We shall now write some scripts in Octave to estimate the clearness index for a given place and also to estimate the coefficients of the Fourier series curve fit model for clearness index and also the water vapor content. Then we shall also see how we use these estimated values of the clearness index in order to estimate the energy incident on a tilted flat plate collector in the presence of atmosphere or atmospheric effects. I have here in this folder few M files. We have already seen errad.m and errad.b.m earlier in an earlier discussion. I have three other files, kt_india.m, wv_india.m and hat_estimate.m. So kt_india.m is a script file which will provide you the coefficients of the Fourier series curve fit model for KT, and wv_india.m will provide the coefficients for the Fourier series curve fit model for the water vapor content in the atmosphere. We shall then later on use the HAT estimate script file to estimate the energy incident on a tilted flat plate collector with atmospheric effects. So first let me open the clearness index script file. The model is given here. You can read this model. Let me probably increase the size of the font, okay, slightly. So this is the model which we already discussed. You see that KT model is a Fourier series model, and we have gone up to the third harmonic in tau. We need to estimate these coefficients, and we have used up to the second power of x and the second power of w, the water vapor content. The water vapor itself is found from another Fourier series curve fit model. I will go into that shortly, and that is in wvindia.m script file. Okay, so what are the inputs? The data are like this. We have the latitude given here, and for the corresponding latitudes and the corresponding day numbers, we have the KT value, the measured KT value, which is basically the ratio of the HA measured by H0 computed. Now this is done for around 12 places distributed all over the country, and you can probably check the latitudes of the 12 places here and check it on the map of India, and which all places fall in that latitude. And we have also taken the water vapor content values as input data. Now using this, x is 5 minus 35, tau is being represented with t, and we are using ai1 plus ai2x plus ai3x square plus ai4w plus AI5W square for the base model. And then you have sine t, sine 2t and sine 3t getting multiplied in cos t, cos 2t, cos 3t also coming into the picture. And then we formulate the matrix and then take the matrix inverse to get the coefficients. Let us execute this to find out the coefficients of KT. So let me go into Octave. So in the Octave, let me clear the screen. Let me go into the folder of interest, and I will execute this kt_india.m, no m, like this. So on executing the script file, you get this matrix. This will be AI1, AI2, sorry, this will be A11, A12, A13, A14, A15, A21, 22, 23, 24, 25, so on. So this will be the coefficients for the Fourier series curve fit model for KT. Likewise, if I look into the wv_india.m, you will see the curve fit model for the water vapor content. Just like as we discussed, you can see the curve fit model given here, and the data is the day number, which is taken as these values here, and the middle of the month, and for these latitudes for the same 12 cities, and the water vapor content input data, measure data is here. And then here we are using the model AI1 plus AI2X plus AI3X square. So it is a three-term second order polynomial. We do the matrix inverses, generate the matrix, and then find out G. So when you execute this, WV India, we get the coefficients of the G matrix, which will fit into this model. So this will be GI1, GI2, and GI3. So you can then get this model. So now we know how to get water vapor, and we can also get the clearness index. Next, we shall look at this file. This file is used for estimating the incident energy on a horizontal or a tilted surface. Now with atmospheric effect, we saw without the atmospheric effects, it is a modification of that file. Now you have a few things added to it. So this is the latitude. I'm using 12.97 Bangalore, and I'm giving the tilt factor as 10, which we saw was the optimal under the without atmospheric conditions. Use tilt factor of that condition, the one without atmosphere. And there is this rho, the reflection coefficient. I'm taking it at 0.2 in the planes. G is the coefficient matrix for the water vapor content. A is the coefficient matrix for the clearness index, and the rest of these equation remain the same as before. The new portion that I have introduced is here, introducing the atmospheric effects, estimation of the water vapor. So those coefficients are put in this model form, and this G is the one that is estimated using wv_india.m. This A was obtained from kt_india.m, and that we use it one time, and we use it only when we have fresh data or probably more number of places to include in the input data. So using that data, we can get water vapor content, and then use that water vapor content estimated into the FX equation of the clearness index, which is 1x x square w w square, and then you will get KT estimate from the KT estimate equation. Then find out RD, the tilt factor, HOT by H naught, then KD, which is basically HD by HA, the diffuse radiation factor. It is approximately given by 1 minus 1.13 to KTE. RT, the overall tilt factor, is given by this relationship which we discussed all earlier. From there, we have these two HA, T, direct, that is without the diffuse and reflected radiation. And the other one is HAT, which is with the atmospheric effects, including the diffused and reflected radiation affecting the tilted surface. So these are the formulas that we have used, and we will just run this and then see what is the result that we would get. So going back to the Octave and clearing the workspace, I will now execute HAT EST. Estimate. So see here that we get this result. This blue line is the H0 kilowatt hour per meter square per day without atmospheric effects on a horizontal flat plate. This green line is a tilted flat plate collector with atmospheric effects. So you see that this is very significantly attenuated from the one without the atmospheric effects, and this is basically due to the clearness index. Now see that for Bangalore, see around here, around 80, which will be March 21st region, we see clear sky and intense radiation. The intensity of the radiation decreases here. You will see a lot of cloud because this is the monsoon region in Bangalore, and you see the intensity reduced, and you see that the minimum value is around 4.6 or so, and so on. It reaches around 6 towards the December months, where again we see clear sky. So the due to KT, that is a clearness index, we will see the local atmospheric effects getting reflected nicely in this fashion. It is interesting to see plot the days versus RD, this is the tilt factor, and versus RT, the overall tilt factor. So you will see that this RD blue line is the tilt factor, and the green line is the overall tilt factor, RT, lowercase RT. So this is actually, though it looks similar in shape, this is actually lower, the value is lower than RD in the earlier months and the later months, and during the monsoon months you see that the RD is lower and the overall tilt factor is having a better value due to the diffuse, because of the cloud, the diffuse part is more and therefore the RT becomes higher. It will also be interesting to plot days and the clearness index, how it varies, and you will see that the variation of the clearness index with day January 1st to December 31st, how it has varied. Again, you see that the clearness index is very nice and better. It is reaching 0.75 during the March months when the sky is clear in Bangalore, and it is reaching a very low figure around 0.45 during the monsoon months. These are the monsoon months. From June to around September, October, and then it picks up again. So KT, the clearness index, actually reflects the atmospheric conditions of that locality there. So the important conclusion is that if you run this HAT estimate, you will get this green line here, which is HAT, the energy incident on the tilted flat plate collector with atmospheric effects, and this is what you have to use for designing the PV panel. Now take in a year, what is the minimum value? You look at that. So this minimum value here, for example, here the place where I have kept the cursor is around 4.6, and that value is the one which you need to take for designing your all your applications, because you are guaranteed 4.6 kilowatt hour per meter square per day of energy, this much amount of energy every day of the year, and in other days you have excess. So the worst case would be this value pointed at by the cursor which is HAT minimum, and this we will use for designing and sizing the PV panels.